terrible. No one survived. Ouch. Terror site ends. Countless lives saved. Hooray! Praise Cinemas for a successful intervention. That's good. Okay, let's save here. Yeah, definitely reverting back the version was a good idea. So how do we deal with these? That's a ground attack. And that is a ground attack. I don't think I can deal with these, actually, to be honest. Intercept those. No. Just go home. Nope. Hello. Hello. I can deal with this one. I need to get those... what was that? Major road bridge destroyed near Timbuktu. And the aliens are having some fun times again. Let's auto-resolve this one. Return the base. Let's do a quick save here. Again. So there is a crash site there. Well, we'll probably have to go there as well. And I probably need to deal with these. Oh well, they're gone. See. Oh, someone actually is. We need to get some new guy. This guy. In the ship. Oh. Did I not? Whoa. Unassigned. Charlie, go. Okay, there we go. And you'll get the. Who is wounded? Beirut Rifleman, okay. So you'll be a rifle dude as well. In a wolf armor, and we'll rename you. I was gonna give, who was it? Let me see. Oh, Eric was going to be in the game, yes. There we go. Private Eric. From West German. Well, pretty close. No combat experience. That's a great guy. You were actually supposed to be a shield dude, but... you'll do fine with those for now. Let's go clear out the crash site there. Medium farm. Let's go in there. Boom him. Yeah, Julia. The main thing about the new version, which I was kind of hoping to actually try out, is the new maps. They added a ton of new maps for the UFO crash sites, especially for the farm and was it the desert missions? Because I would love to get more variation of the on the maps, but shame we couldn't use those due to the crashing issue. I think you can actually add those manually into the game as well. Because the biggest problem in the new XCOM and in this game as well early on was that there is not enough different maps. You'll really quickly play the same map over and over again, which kinda sucks. So having variety on the missions is really good. That's what I liked from the original XCOM and especially Terror from the Deep, that there was a lot of different maps. Although they had a lot of repeating as well, but I think they still had way more variety in the map setups. Hey Morgolds, how's it going? And so this is a farm again. And these farm maps actually are pretty bad, in my opinion. Oh, okay. How about no? That's a Reaper. I'm a soldier after you. I will be naming some more people soon, probably surfers, and I'll be giving out soldiers for people. We need a Paizo in there again, and some other people. I have a bunch of soldiers in the other base, but I haven't named any of those because I'm probably not gonna be using them at all, except for base defense. So I don't really wanna name those guys, at least for now. Nice. Good shot. Those Reapers, which just died there, is a melee unit that kills you instantly if it gets into melee range. And it actually turns your guy into a zombie. And when the zombie dies, it actually spawns one more of these. So they are extremely deadly and annoying. Soldier, aliens. You would like a sure. Let's see when I get more. When I get the new dropship, which is already building, I'll be hiring a bunch more people. I should actually have some people to swap around as well. So I'll be hiring a group of more people in a moment. And just naming people. We need to actually build some more weapons as well. For the peoples. But I would definitely give you a shotgun. Zangief. I may actually swap around these for my shield guy there. The shield guys have pistols, but maybe I'll actually give a shotgun for them with the shield. If they have enough strength to use them. I mean both of them, because the shield is really heavy. With the armor and everything. So it's not really optimal, but... would be actually better than the pistol. Even though the pistol has been really decent, like in the previous mission, we did a lot of damage with the pistols. Let's actually throw some flares in there. There we go. I think that's a disc, probably, with those million shots. One big difference to the original XCOMs and the new XCOM is also that there's a lot of reaction fire from your guys. It was really rare to get actually a reaction shot out of your own guys. Aliens were doing reaction shots every damn turn. If you move, you die, pretty much. But your guys never pretty much did reaction shots, except very rarely, so you couldn't really rely on them. But in this one, actually, if you leave some time units, you will get some reaction shots, which is really, really nice. And compared to the new XCOM, where you pretty much do only one reaction shot ever, it is a massive difference. Actually having time units is a massive difference already, but... that's where I think the new XCOM went really wrong, when they removed time units and just had a certain amount of actions per turn. Let's see... yeah, let's just run. I wonder if there's only one Reaper in these ships. Only seen one every time, so hopefully there is no more. I really dislike doing these missions in the nighttime. Although that is very faithful for the original game. I absolutely hated night missions in that one as well. You could see nothing at all. Also the lack of maps and enormous amount of bugs. Yeah, pretty much. Although I did still like the game. It was a really, really nice game. Oh, hello. And I played a shit ton out of that as well. But they did some really bad choices in that one. Yeah, the Geoscape was kind of totally useless in the new one. There was like no point to it. It was just there. That's the one of the main things that Julian Kolob, who made the original XCOM, was complaining about the new one as well, that the Geoscape was totally useless in the new one. And you couldn't build more bases than just having the main one. Yeah, definitely Sigaris. I mean, it was definitely not a good game. I loved it. But they could have made it even better. Ouch. I think there's two discs there, maybe. The alien movement in the new one is really bad as well. Since they are teleporting around as much as they are trying to tell it is a bug. Okay, there is definitely a two discs. Come on. I was kinda hoping to kill both of them in one hit, but I guess not. Yeah, curry. That's really nice of the old game. Move out of the ship, everyone dies. Or not even move out of the ship. Just open the door, see an alien, die. Yeah, definitely Sigaris. But hopefully the success of the new XCOM shows people that people actually do like these games, and they make more of these. Because I'm absolutely loving the every single one of these games. And I would love to play even more. And I actually hope they make a sequel for the new XCOM as well. Even if it's not gonna be as good as the old ones, but... still. Oh, hello. Like what they did with the smoke grenades, remove vision blocking and making it an accuracy penalty instead. Yeah, definitely Sigaris, that is a good change. Although they did some changes to that as well in the new patch. I think the civilians are actually immune to the smoke now. So you cannot smoke the civilians because they are space lizards. So they see through the smoke. That is a great miss. Looks like every bullet hit, but everything actually missed. That's a good chance last time. We are supposed to be immune. Oh, yeah. And they also regen now. The XCOM FPS failed. Yeah, it did. Pretty much. At Basilisk, I think. Open XCOM, the fan-made XCOM game. I haven't actually heard about that. Have you played that one, Papa Manbeer? And is it good? Oh, actually, is that the one where you have the multiplayer? As I mean, you can play as the aliens against the other players. Yes. Similar to the old one. Yeah, definitely Nessus. Shame, many of the new turn-based ones have been, well, pretty shit actually. Like the new Jak the Lions, it's garbage. Especially the online version that is free to play. I really didn't like it. And I haven't played the new one, but it looks, and what I've heard, it is pretty bad. Reverse engineered XCOM using all the original assets. Ooh, that sounds so nice. I may have to take a look at that. Does it play like the old one? Like totally same as the old one? Because a big issue with the old one for me is that it plays pretty badly on the new PCs, especially considering streaming it or anything. It's a bit annoying to get working. Ooh, hello. So if I can get an open version that works really well, well, better. I would definitely wanna give it a go. Only the images are the same, okay. The stats and mechanics are identical, it's just new engine that. Oh, nice cigarettes. That sounds really good. Lot of optional stuff like improved AI and such. I'll have to take a look at it. Let me actually open the link so I can check it out after the stream and I don't forget it. Because my head is like totally useless. I don't remember anything I see after 5 seconds. Especially if I'm streaming, so I need to make reminders for myself to actually take a look. My version of the XCOM original crashed a lot. Yeah, that's the old one. The old one crashes even on the older operating systems too much. I was actually trying to stream the XCOM Apocalypse at some point, and I just couldn't do it because of the crash issues and everything. It's just so annoying to have it crash every now and then, and it also plays pretty badly. Open XCOM is what got you back into gaming. Nice, Papa Man Bear. I really like that there is a lot of these open versions of different games being made by fans of the series, like OpenTDD, Transport Tycoon Deluxe. Is really, really good as well. And some other ones I would also like to play. Like Open Master of Orion 2, sounds really good. And there was some other one as well being made, which I would definitely give a go when they are bit more fleshed out. I think the last aliens are in the ship. Yeah, it is definitely a lot different from the other ones, Curry. But it is a really nice game. The Fallen Haven. Don't think I've heard about that one. At least it doesn't ring any bells. Open Red Alert and Dune. Yeah, actually, I need to test out the Open Dune as well. I really loved the original Dune. I mean, not Dune 2. Used to play a lot of that. Ever heard? Yeah, Papa Man Bear. I've heard about that like years and years ago. But I've never actually seen it or tested that one myself. Yeah, there is night puzzles, but shame a lot of them never actually get anywhere. Oh, hello. Freeze him and free call. Yep. How do we actually see that one? That is kinda interesting. Who actually sees that one? Oh. That may be a line of sight bug. I would say. Seeing the alien through the hull of the ship. Maybe it's a window. Command and Conquer Tiberian Sun. Ooh. That would be really nice to try as well. I really love the Command and Conquer series. Especially the older ones. Lots of line of sight bugs, especially with the later multi-level ships. Ah, that sucks. Sicarius. I've never got into the multi-level ships. I think we lost the game when I think it was the large ones were coming out. Wearing the X-ray specs he found in the captain's crunch. Nice. Rebel Star Tactical Command. Hmm. There used to be also, what was it called? Laser Squad or something like that. A really old turn-based tactical game. Was done Commodore or something like that, and it was really really fun. This is on normal Sicarius, because I actually wanted to get through the game at least once, and then I can pump up the difficulty. Let's see. Ooh, 6 time units. Ooh, those are gonna be helpful. Eric got pretty nice stats. And I'm going through puberty again, it seems. Yes. Okay. I want the. Can you make the rose thingy, the red one that we have in? Not that one. I mean the one I drank when I was yes, that one. When I was working in the. Two. Laser Squad is an Amiga game. Yeah. Was it an Amiga game? Well, anyways, I'm not. How did I play that then? Because I never had that Amiga myself. I only know that it was really, really good. Got to Operation Endgame twice. First time, version 20, experimental branch, final map was broken. Second time, version 21, experimental, and the psi powers make it impossible. Yeah, Sicarius, I read the patch notes. For the experimental 22, that they actually reduced the amount of Psy dudes to half or something. So if I get that far in this playthrough, we may be pumping the version to 22 for the last mission, and try to not crash too much to actually be able to do it. I heard you get pretty much constantly mind controlled and all kinds of stuff. Ooh. Scimitar support tank. That is cool. Dropship space 2. Did they actually change the amount of space it takes? I think it was 4 before on these vehicles. Which was definitely too much. Oh, removal of driver. It's a drone controlled tank. That's cool. I want one of these. Oh. Hmm. This could be an issue. Having a hard time getting started. Yeah, you might want to wait, Papa Man Beer, till the end of next month. So basically a month or so. The full release is supposed to come out in a month. Or a bit more. So you might as well just wait a bit more and play the full version and not this early access one. They're gonna be doing, I suppose it's 6 weeks of polish, and then it's gonna be in a release state. So I have nothing to research at the moment. That is not good. 3 days for the new dropship. And there's the tank. Let's do a save here. It's kind of strange having nothing to research this early on. Let's roll the time a bit more. Name Surfos. Make him a rifle. Actually, let me check the aircraft Shrike. So this is the one we are building at the moment. VTOL aircraft. That's 12 soldiers rather than 8. So we can get 4 more people in there. That's pretty nice. Or 2 more and a tank. I think we are gonna go with 2 more and a tank. So let's hire a couple more people. And we could use some extra, to be honest. So let's hire people. Let's see. Cory Cross looks pretty good with accuracy. And Braver is actually pretty good as well. Hans looks pretty amazing. Lots of time units, lots of health, lots of everything pretty much. So you are hired at least. Marta looks pretty good as well. Yeah, she has also a really amazing name. Marta Degli Esposti. Good accuracy. Good reflex. Shit health and strength, but what can you do? Could be worse, like the Thomas. Lucy looks actually pretty good as well. And Alvin looks good. Let's get Alvin. And let's get Marta. This is gonna be a sniper, definitely. Heavy dude, I think. And something, I don't know. Yeah, let's get those. The game UFO Alien Invasion is starting to look very good as well. Let's open that one as well. So I remember to check it out. So let's get those 3 people, do a save here. I need to build equipment for those guys as well, but let's just wait for the dropship and the people to arrive. Production of Shrike is done. Hooray. That is really cool. Let's remove the people from the Charlie to Shrike. I think I'm gonna have to run a couple people without the armor for now. So all of you guys get into the ship. I think that's... Can't count. That's 9 people. So one more is gonna get in, and we are gonna get the... Let's get this one in there as well, for now. And let's go building. I'm gonna need armor for the people. I'm gonna get more Buzzard armors, I think. And now let's get the Wolf Battle armor. I need 3 more, 4 more. 10 days. I need more workshops, actually, as well. Let's make those, and then we're gonna need the guns. And let's go here. I wonder if I should make this one into my workshop base, actually. Build the stuff here and relocate them through transfer into the other base. That may be actually a good idea. Yeah, let's do it. Let's see. Workshop. How much is this, by the way? 100,000. Ugh. Let's make 2. In the original XCOM, I usually had the main base,